some good things about you, so I wanted to see face-to-face who you were.
I'm glad we got that introduction out of the way.
Yeah.
Mr. Remick.
Mr. Bob, I got a question for you.
Sure.
Had a person call me, they had a severe water line break on their property up at, I guess, the Dollar Store off Telegraph, Champaign area. And it's my understanding that, I guess it was on his property. Years ago, I remember, under heavy circumstances, the city doesn't do any repair whatsoever on private property problems?
No.
On water main breaks or anything?
We don't spend any.
Anything that's on their property, they have to do themselves?
Correct. There's an easement on a lot of these new developments. We're required by the MDEQ to acquire easements for these water services, but a lot of the older buildings don't have them. But some, the newer ones, we actually have agreements, easement agreements.
The thing that concerns me is if we have a tremendous amount of water flowing from that pipe outside there, the person who's, the water main breaks on his property, we're the ones having to pay for the water.
That's correct.
And if that person doesn't get it fixed right away, and there's nothing that's, do we give them a time they have to get it fixed?
Absolutely. We give them a timeframe, and we'll tell them we're gonna shut the water off, because it is.
And that concerns me. I mean, usually how long do we give somebody?
Usually a day or two, day.
Which means a tremendous amount of water's flowing.
But I think we give them an estimated bill of water loss, don't we?
No, there's no way for us to give them an estimated water loss.
Because I was just wondering, man, if the water line is big enough, we'll lose a tremendous amount of water. I saw what it did here in 15 minutes. I can imagine what a water line along that outside line would be pouring out for a couple of days or so, maybe a lot. So there's nothing, I guess I understand, but you would think that if our crews are there and we find out maybe they could have done the job to build that businessman, they would probably be very happy to pay our bill to have to go, first of all, they gotta go find somebody to come in and dig it. And our crews are sitting right there, just go ahead, let them do it, and send them a bill.
That's something we'd have to talk to council about, working on private property, because there's liability issues for employees.
Yeah.
And we strictly have a policy that we do not work on private property.
Okay, thank you.
Any other questions? All right, item 23 is a motion to approve contract number as stated between the Michigan Department of Transportation and the City of Taylor for the resurfacing of Goddard Road from Telegraph Road to Party Road, and authorize the mayor and clerk to sign said contract. Mr. Mayhew, do you wanna go over this?
Yes, this is a standard contract between MDOT and municipalities for the use of federal funds for repairing streets. And this is the resurfacing of Goddard Road from Telegraph to Party. The road will be milled, the asphalt surface will be milled off, face repairs made, ADA ramps constructed or corrected where in violation, and 4 inches of asphalt total top down this road area. So this is a standard contract that sets forward the cost participation agreements and other obligations by both parties. I handed out another sheet. At the time that this was put together for council agenda, we didn't know what the bid cost for the construction would be, and it came in higher, 13% higher than what was estimated. So the sheet that I handed out is a new spreadsheet or cost estimate based on the actual bid price, the cost of engineering by MSC engineers, and that was the contract that was approved previously. But that cost will be part of the participation cost that will be funded by MDOT.
Okay, so this is going to be coming out of the major street fund?
Yes.
Okay. Is there any questions about Mr. Johnson?
Are we looking at the rest of Goddard Road too?
We're currently working on a list for the budget, for the upcoming budget year.
Sure.
And we do use the HAZA ratings and the condition of the roads. A lot of the HAZA ratings are the same.
Because I know we did Goddard with that, pick it up and put it back down a few years ago. I mean, all one process. And they did Part E, so I didn't know if Part E and the rest of that was all in. So are we looking at that? Pretty soon.
Mr. Mayhew.
Every year, the Federal Aid Committee seeks project suggestions from the cities, and we've been putting in Pardee Road, Beach Daily, and Goddard Road, and Wick Road as candidates. And we've been fortunate, we've gotten two sections of Beach Daily, we got another section coming up from Brest to Wick in 2019, and but every year we've been down, and we've been fortunate that they've been picking out roads for us.
Through the chair, you're not familiar with the FAC program that you just said. It's a pot of money that every community in Wayne County is fighting over. Exactly. It's a defined amount, and it goes on need, and you just keep putting these roads on the list, and hopefully you keep moving up, and when money's available, then it comes out to us.
Does the county dictate, like, do they present a list to communities, like, of what street, you know, like Angie was saying, E-Course, especially like E-Course and Beach Daily area, is literally a minefield.
There is a list that FAC provides that the roads that are scheduled to get done this year and the future years, based on estimated amounts of money that they receive.
The county could help us with E-Course.
Mr. Chair? Sorry, just a quick question. Just point of interest, should we put amount not to exceed on this motion? Thought if we have some of the numbers.
Yeah, there's a lot wrong with this. So let's put that amount, and then we'll also change the state of Taylor slightly as well.
Yeah.
So we'll do not to exceed.
Mr. Chair, not to exceed, and also fund it through major roads.
Okay. Okay, thank you. Anything else, Charlie, do you have anything else? We're going to go up to item 24, is a motion to approve election programming charges from Dominion Voting Systems Incorporated, state vendor, for the amount not to exceed $3,510. Funds allocated through General Fund Clerk's Office Election Supplies. Clerk Office.
This is for the 2017 election programming. It's a new company. I had been asking them for months to give me the amount so I could at least see if it was going to be over 2,000, if they needed council approval. So it was over 2,000. They actually just mailed me the bills without any warning. They were kind of behind me, well past the elections. But anyways, my goal is in July is just to bring it out to exceed item so that at least have a CCR before the work is done.
So will that be like pretty much the same for the 2018?
Maybe a little higher or more on the ballot.
Yeah.
So I'm going to bump it. Probably bump it. Yeah. Yeah.
Is there anything for the clerk on this? All right, going at item 25 is actually a solicitation request from All Saints Knights of Columbus to hold their annual Tootsie Roll Drive from March 23rd to the 25th, 2018. Anything on this? All right, item 26 is a motion to approve the fiscal year 17-18 budget amendment dated February 6, 2018. Mr. Petrucci?
Yes. Mr. Chairman, what you have presented there is kind of like a little bit of a cleanup budget amendment for a few items that were approved by the council at previous meetings last couple months, and also some items that were on this agenda. For example, DPW salt, there needed to be a budget amendment there based on the approval of the item at this current agenda. And then a couple things in regards to a couple cleanups of grants, home grant revenue, home grant expense, net zero. In the fire department, there was purchase of some that pickup truck that was approved at a council meeting before a couple months ago. And so we're just kind of cleaning up the budget for some of those items that weren't presented at that time. I believe that, I think the documents all stated that the budget was forthcoming. So. So that's really what this is, but the larger ticket items is the, like I said, the salt, the trucks in the fire department, a couple of the expenses in the motor vehicle pool, and Act 48 expenses in DW, which is offset. Act 48 is a restricted fund balance, so any use of that will go out of the restricted fund balance, not the unassigned fund balance. So I think I put a note on there too as well.
Okay. Is there any questions about the budget amendment?
Yeah.
All right. That is the last item. Anybody else have anything? Anything else about anything?
All right. I got one.
Oh, sure.
You know, I've heard a lot of conversations we keep hearing.